All right, so here is my basic architecture for a temperature triggered Ifttt. So this is what we're doing, right? So a temperature sensor is writing to my computer on a CSV file, so it's logging temperature data. I have a script that's running, that's looking for that temperature and looking to see if the temperature ever gets above a predetermined threshold. If the temperature ever gets above a predetermined threshold, it sends a webhook to Ifttt service, which will then be used to either trigger an email or a text message. So walk through how this can all be done now. So Ifttt is ifttt.com. I am going to sign in, and I'm going to use my Google account to sign in. So when I sign in, if it's a first time, you might be asked to put in a PIN that gets sent to your email address, but I've done it before, so here I am. So what we want to do is create our own applet. So click on this tiny user account right here and say create. So the first thing we want to do is we'll create an email alert if the temperature ever gets. So Ifttt, if something, whatever the trigger is, then do something. So our trigger is going to be the webhook. So the trigger is going to be this webhook sent whenever the temperature is above a threshold. So the script on my computer is looking to see if the temperature is above a threshold. When it's above a threshold, it sends this webhook, right? Sends this webhook. So my Ifttt is looking for a webhook. So just search for webhook. So how did we get here? We clicked on this, create, and then we got to that window. Search for webhook. I'm going to choose webhook. And then when I get to this, we want to choose a trigger. So we want to receive a web request. And let's give the web request, when it comes in, it needs a name. So let's call it a temp email trigger. So that's the name of the trigger, is the temp email. So create a trigger. Now what we want to do with it is there's a number of options we can do. So the first thing we want to try is an email, if we want to send an email. All right, so I want to send me an email. So the first time you do it, you might be asked for a PIN to verify that email. But what we want is, here's a subject line, occurred on something webhook service. You can change this to whatever you want. I'm just going to say, give it a very short alert. Temperature is above threshold. Okay, so that's the subject line. And in the body, what happened? Event name. What happened? Temperature is currently. So what we want is we want to add an ingredient. We'll call it value 1, degrees Fahrenheit. So this temperature is currently this. Temperature has currently this. When did this happen? We can add the ingredient called occurred at. So this will give you the date and time at which this happened. And it's all HTML type coded. So we'll put a line break there, a line break there. So that's it. So we've created a subject line that says alert temperatures above threshold. If you want to add, let's say, a time, and then that's that subject line will also have that time, and then what temperature is currently at a particular value, and we'll send this ingredient. So we're going to create that action. When this action gets created, so this is the action created, we'll call it finish. Okay, so we've now created actually a temperature monitoring system, which is going to send us an email whenever we hit a particular threshold. So in order to test it, let's go back to our home. So let's go to home. When we go to home, we're going to see this webhook. We need the particular address of our webhook. So let me go to webhook and show you how to get that address. So one thing you want to click on webhook, click on documentation. When you click on documentation, this is your unique code. This is your unique code. The event name is the name that we gave to our, that's the event name, temp underscore email. So If I want to create a, you can do it using a variety of ways. Create a form, post. If you want to do it using CURL, you can do that. Let's create a temp underscore email. And the value one, let's say the temperature had reached 859 degrees Fahrenheit. Okay, so that's what this single line CURL looks like. We can test it right from here and see if that actually triggers our email. So I'm going to pull up my email right here, and I'm going to hit test it. And what I might find is that I have an email. Webhook alert: temperatures above threshold on April 6, 2020 at 9:17 p.m. So when I click on this, it says temperature is currently 859 Fahrenheit when that. So that's a succinct message we sent via email. Okay. So again, we've looked at how to do this part. So Ifttt with an email alert. Next, we're going to try an Ifttt with a text alert. But before you start this, what you need to do is you actually need, in order to be able to send a text message, you actually need to have the Ifttt app installed on your phone. So if you are on Android, and this works on Android, I haven't tried it on iOS, but it works on Android. So go, I've installed this Ifttt app on my phone, and I've signed in with my Ifttt account on my phone. So now I can use my phone to send a text message, or Ifttt can use my phone's text messaging service as a way to text any number that we designate in our webhook in just a second. Okay, so let's set up this branch of it. So once Ifttt is installed on your phone and you've saved it, then you let's proceed back to right here. Let's go proceed back here now. Right? So I'm going to create a new webhook, and I'm going to create again a new trigger, and the trigger is again going to be a webhook. But instead of doing, and this time I'm going to call it a temp SMS create, instead of the service being email, so last time we did email, this time we'll do SMS, and we get Android SMS. So the action is to send an SMS from your Android device to any phone number you specify. So we are here. Let's just first go and see what message we want to send. Let's say temperature is up, is currently add ingredient value 1. That's where we decided we'll put the temperature Fahrenheit, which is above threshold set time. Okay, so it'll put the date, the temperature, and maybe something like alert. Temperature is currently a particular value, and then now go ahead and enter your phone number here. So that's what we want to do next, is just put in our phone number to whatever number you want to send. You can include only one phone number. So I entered my phone number, create an action. And this would take just a second, so it created the action, finish it. Before I move on, I also decide to click keep this checked in. So not only does it send me a text message, it will also email me when that alert is sent out. So let me finish. So now let's go back to the webhook that I had, and in this time, instead of sending it to my email, I am going to use the webhook I had set up, and I had called it temp SMS, by the way. So if I go to my home, I should see webhooks, two webhooks, temp email that I sent earlier, temp SMS that I just created. So that's the event name I'm looking for. So temp SMS, and let's change the value to, let's say, 923 Fahrenheit. So again, I'm going to test it using curl. Event has been triggered. So let's find out. So I just got a beep on my phone that says temp SMS has occurred, and a new text message was sent. So let's see if I received that. So here you go. I see that I've received a text message that says the temperature has risen. And here is the message I just received that says alert, temperature is currently 923°F, which is above set threshold time April 6, 2020 at 9:23 p.m. So that's the message that I just received by just testing it using this trigger. Now, okay, so we've tested using curl, so you can do this directly from the command line. You can do an equivalent from Java or Python. I have a simple, I've taken this thing and converted it to a simple Python script. So I have a very simple Python script that's basically going to send a different temperature value. In this case, I just says 1024. I'm going to hit run. So it's basically making that same request to that my specific URL that I have. I'm going to hit run. And so this is run. So and I just got a Ifttt alert on my phone. And here it is. The temperature reading is currently 1024, which is above set threshold time at 9:31 p.m. So you can use a Python script or JavaScript or something else to send this webhook to your phone or your email. Since I had set up my email to go off as well as my SMS message, I should have received an email as well. So I have a, there it is. So I have a new alert about the temperature here as well. So, all right, so that's how you use Ifttt to basically take a temperature reading that's saved in a log file that gets triggered whenever the temperature is above a certain threshold.